Now we'll study about types of transformers. Here we can write that based on output voltage in secondary coil of transformer. Here I am abbreviating transformer by the term TX. Now we can write based on output voltage in secondary coil of transformer. These are classified in two categories. The first one we call step up transformer, and the second one we call step down transformer. Step up transformer is the one where we can write E2 is more than E1. For a given transformer, the voltage which is applied on the primary coil, if it is E1, in the output terminal, the voltage which is available at the secondary coil, this E2, which is more than E1, or we can say the output voltage E2 is more than input voltage which is applied, then such a transformer we call a step-up transformer. And as we know, in case of an ideal transformer, power remains constant. If output is connected across a load resistance and a current is drawn I2 from it, and I1 is the current in the primary coil, here we can write that E1 I1 is equals to E2 I2. So we can write as E2 is more than E1. So by transformer equation we can write E2 by E1 is equals to N2 by N1. If E2 is more than E1, here we can write N2 must be more than N1. Using the turns ratio, we can adjust the output voltage whichever is required. And here if E2 is more, here we can write if E2 is more than E1, this implies the value of current at the secondary coil which can be drawn maximum will be less than the current in the primary coil. So in the output circuit or the secondary coil circuit, the current will be certainly less than the current in the primary coil, because the overall power remains constant in case of an ideal transformer. Similarly, we can define step down transformer as the one. This is a transformer in which we can write E2 is less than E1 here. As the voltage is stepping down, we call it a step down transformer. So in this situation, for the same situation, if this is the transformer with this primary coil connected with the EMF E1 and a current I1 is flowing, here we can write in the secondary coil the voltage E2 will be less than E1, because here the number of turns in the secondary coil will be less than the number of turns in the primary coil. By the transformer equation directly we can state, and if a load resistance is connected over here and a current I2 flows, then here also we can write if E2 is less than E1, this implies the current in the secondary coil I2 will be more than current in the primary coil. So the maximum current which can be drawn in the state when the EMF across the secondary coil is E2. Here in this situation, you must be very careful that power in either situation remain constant, but depending on the number of turns ratio in the primary and secondary coil, the EMF of the secondary coil can be stepped up or can be stepped down. Based on this, we can define a step up or a step down transformers.